welcome to this very special episode of Access. Today we profile a very successful parliamentarian, though he is known more for his radical views that often generate a controversy. But the unique aspect here is that first he and now his father have been the sole member of parliament from the party, and yet they have been able to leave a mark over the years because his family has represented the Hyderabad constituency for 9 consecutive terms. Today we spend our entire day with AIMIM President Barrister Asaduddin Owaisi.
Adab, madam. Good morning.
Hey, sir. How are you?
Fine.
So, how does the entire day look today? What are we going
to
do?
So, we have to go and I'll be campaigning today in Chandrayanagutta Assembly constituency.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll be doing a padyatra over there in the morning and the afternoon.
Okay.
And then there'll be a public meeting in the evening.
Public meeting in the evening. That's how the day ends.
Day ends, yes.
Okay. Come, sir. Come. So something about this constituency of yours, since we are going there, is that people here tell me that obviously 9 terms that your family has represented this constituency, they still say that this part of Hyderabad, the old city Hyderabad, still remains very underdeveloped when compared to other parts of the city. For example, the metro that runs in other parts, it's not running in old city Hyderabad. Why is that? Why has this development not been brought?
So the first thing is that people who are telling you these things are basically lying through their teeth. The first point is metro has come to old city.
Okay.
Metro has come in Hyderabad parliament constituency. No, it is there.
Okay.
Now there is one stretch in my parliament constituency where the work is yet to start. I agree with that. So anyway, so now when we are going to my constituency, I will, you know, you will see for yourself.
Yeah.
The work which we have done or not done.
This is also the area that your brother is representing.
Yes, Akbar is the MLA from this constituency.
And you know, people do, maybe not inside Hyderabad, I'm not very aware of you know, how the narrative goes here, but outside of Hyderabad, clearly there's a view that he is the more radical face of the party. That you know, the kind of statements that he gives.
There is so much of scrutiny nowadays. Anything which I say becomes a 9 p.m.
debate
for 9 p.m. nationalists. So, you know, I would ask you how many times have Times now done a 9 p.m. show on Akbaruddin Owaisi in last, let us say, 3 months.
Okay.
No, you have not done, you have done more on me. Does that make me radical? ख्याल रखिए 11 अप्रैल के दिन सलाम वालेकुम आप तमाम जो वोट की जरूरत है सलाम वालेकुम 11 अप्रैल को आप तमाम लोग निकल के वोट डालना है 11 अप्रैल को मजलिस वोट देकर कामयाब करिए सलाम वालेकुम दुआ फरमाइए वोट डालिए कैसा भी
Mr. Owaisi, in 2014 when the Prime Minister said, Achhe din aayenge, tell me 2019 now, 5 years down the line, aapki constituency mein, achhe din aa gaye aapke logon ke?
For the Prime Minister and for his party, you find them hardly using that statement anymore. You never find the Prime Minister...
Why do you think that is?
No, that I want the Prime Minister to say, Achhe din aa gaye, let him say that in his speech. He has stopped using it. You don't find BJP people now, instead of Achhe Din, they are saying you're Chowkidar.
When people say Asaduddin Owaisi is B team BJP, what do you have to say? Your B team BJP is the criticism from your detractors.
I'm A team. What
does A team mean?
I don't know, you must ask Rahul Gandhi and all these Congress people who have devised all this B team, A team, that team, no team. So if you are with them, you are with their team. The moment you oppose them, you become B team.
Why haven't you decided to join the Mahagathbandhan? the whole Mahagathbandhan coming together.
Congress with Mamta in West Bengal?
No, they're not.
Is Congress with Sapa and BSP? No.
The Sapa BSP said no.
No. Is Congress... where is... I don't know where is Congress.
The Congress there in Maharashtra. The Congress trying for alliance in Jammu and Kashmir.
Yeah. As far as Maharashtra is concerned, I am with Prakash Ambedkar. I had openly, publicly stated...
Yeah.
That please take Prakash Ambedkar, give him the respect which is due to him. The arrogance of Congress party is so much, they don't even want to speak to Prakash Ambedkar. That is the problem.
Okay, so it is April 11, Asad Dubara. दो मिनट बात कर सकते हो। क्या नाम हो आपका?
महमूदा।
तो महमूदा जी, इस बार असदुद्दीन जी एक बार और फिर से लड़ रहे हैं यहाँ से, हैदराबाद से
जी।
आप लोग खुश हैं इनके काम से?
हाँ,
खुश है।
हाँ, सुकून से है यहाँ पर।
सुकून से है?
हाँ, झगड़ा हो कुछ नहीं, हर चीज की सहूलत है, नल की, इसकी।
ओके।
हाँ,
यहाँ मेट्रो वेट्रो तो आई नहीं, यहाँ बड़ी बड़ी कंपनी आई नहीं,
वो गरीब लोग इसमें खुश है। हाँ, इसमें खुश है, गरीब लोग हैं ना, ज्यादा नहीं है ना इधर।
हाँ,
कुछ भी,
गरीब लोग ऐसे ही खुश है।
हाँ, ऐसे ही खुश है, दौलत वाले दौलत में खुश है, गरीब लोग गरीब में खुश है।
कुछ कमी नहीं इस जगह में?
नहीं, अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह, हमारे एरिया में तो कुछ कमी नहीं है, इंशाल्लाह।
नहीं, इस तरीके से इलेक्ट्रिसिटी है, देखो कैसे तार खींचे हुए हैं,
तो
रोड अच्छे नहीं है, सड़क पे पानी,
रोड दो साल पर साल भर पड़े पड़े अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह। सुने, और क्या है, ये बस्ती पहले छोटी थी, अब बस्ती और बढ़ती जा रही है, उस वजह से रोडा छोटे होते आ रहे, उस वजह से काम अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह, काम तो चल रहे हैं अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह, अल्लाह का शुक्र है,
काम चल रहे
हैं अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह।
Do you see the likelihood of a non-BJP, a non-Congress front coming up post 2019?
I feel that's a very ideal situation to have. To have a non-Congress, non-BJP government.
It's ideal situation, but is it a real situation? Is it realistic?
You know, I would definitely not rule it out, because you see this whole binary of either Rahul Gandhi or Mr. Modi.
Yeah.
I don't think so. That is a very right thing to say, because if you're saying that, then you're assuming that there are no qualified leaders in India
apart from these two.
That would be really wrong to say.
Huh. If Jagan goes with BJP, where does that leave Asaduddin Owaisi?
Where does that leave? It will not leave me anywhere. I will still be supporting KCR. I will be opposing BJP. Simple as that. But you see,
Jagan.
These are all you're speculating. I am assuming, I am hoping, and I am pretty
You're
much sure.
Hoping he doesn't
no,
go.
No, no, no. I am hoping that there will be a non-Congress, non-BJP government, and Modi will not be the Prime Minister. What is wrong in that?
Okay, assume that Jagan goes with the BJP. What is wrong
in
that?
He will not go. Because you see, BJP has this great Midas touch. Anyone who touches BJP gets burned politically. And Jagan knows that. KCR also knows it. This question, which has always been put forward by secular and so-called liberal people sitting in Delhi. Why are you going with KCR? What about Jagan? What will happen? My question to them is, why don't you ask your alma mater Congress party, are you going to cross 100 or not?
You think they're going to cross?
No, it is for them to answer. There is a direct fight between BJP and Congress where there are no regional parties, 100 parliament seats. This is my assessment. Can Congress get 70, 80 seats from there? Can Congress get 120? Good, get it. You get it, the game is on. 150 boss, you become the new chowkidar.
Who does Asaduddin Owaisi want to see as the new chowkidar of India?
Who? I want, I know, I
Rahul
don't.
Rahul Gandhi or Narendra Modi?
No, I don't want a chowkidar. I want an imandar. I want a person who believes in India's constitution. You know, who understands the ethos of this constitution. I don't want a prime minister to stand up and say Khabrastan, Shamshan, 1200 saal ki gulami ke baad satta mili hai. You know, I want a prime minister who will stick to the constitution. Simple as that.
Okay. So out of these regional leaders, Mr. Owaisi, just want to understand, who do you think is best qualified for the position?
Everyone is qualified. Everyone is qualified. नाले में गड्ढा है, गैस निकल रहा है, पाइप डाल के चाय बनाए, या चाय कौन बनाते? अब आप ये बताइए, आप नाले में से गैस लेके ये चाय बनाते या गैस का सिलेंडर बनाते? कैसे बनाते आप? गैस से बनाते, नाले की में गैस नहीं. एटलीस्ट दैट विल नॉट बी सेड. एंड थर्डली, एनीवन ही और शी बिकम्स विल नॉट गो अनइनवाइटेड टू पाकिस्तान. यू विल नॉट गो अनइनवाइटेड टू पाकिस्तान. These are what this nation wants.
Okay, I'm amused that all the names that you took, not even once did you take the name of Chandra Babu Naidu. Why is that, sir?
He's a gone, he's an expiry date product. That product is finished. Time, time. Salaam alaikum. Dua farmaiye. Zara khayal rakhiye. Salaam alaikum. दुआ फरमाइए. चलिए आइए. खामोश खामोश. दिस इज द स्कूल बिल्डिंग विच हैज बीन कंस्ट्रक्टेड बाय अकबर.
ओके.
एंड ही हैज कंस्ट्रक्टेड 9 such buildings.
Yes,
and nearly 9,000 children are studying free of cost. The rule only is that he does a draw in this locality.
Okay.
And one from each family.
One from each family.
One from each family. That's it.
Achha, you'll not take two from one family.
No, because the idea is that every family should have a boy or girl educated right up to class 10.
It's a co-ed school, this one?
It's a co-ed school. Lord, advance me in knowledge. That is how much focus there on in religion on learning knowledge.
On knowledge.
But our leaders have stuck to jihad only.
Where did the blacksmith stand? The blacksmith stood under a spreading chestnut tree.
And?
What was the real name of Swami Vivekananda? The real name of Swami Vivekananda was Narendranath Datta.
Very good.
And so, what is your father does?
Ola cab driving.
Ola cab driver hai?
Yes.
Okay.
My name is Fevinas.
Okay. Mama kya karti hai? Ammi kya karti hai?
Kaam.
Kahan kaam karti hai?
Tailoring karti
hai. Tailoring karti hai. Okay. Aur aapko, aap kitne samay se ho school mein?
4 years.
4 years.
We run an MBA college, an MCA college, School of Architecture, Pharmacy, School of Nursing. A scheduled bank, cooperative bank is also run. Now, after running all these institutes of learning and bank, we are still called anti-nationals. What can I say? I just laugh at them. I said, I don't even pity them. You know, I said, we don't know what we are.
So where are you taking us, sir, now that we've finished your
padyatra? We are now going to the Owaisi hospital.
Okay.
Which are trust funds and it is part of the medical college.
There's a medical college and a hospital.
Is so we are going over there now.
Okay. And how many patients per year would you be able to treat in this hospital?
Now you see, there's another hospital called Princess Asra Hospital.
Okay.
And So the advantage of, the benefit to the poor in Asra Hospital is that in 500 rupees we do dialysis over there.
Achha.
And all those medical treatments are done on no loss, no profit basis.
We set up this medical college in 1984. Okay. It was recognized by the MCI in 1992. Mm-hmm. And today we have an intake of approximately 150 students every year. Mm-hmm. And these are they come through a central examination, they are selected, and then the merit students come here. So most of these guys are very, very highly motivated.
On an average day, we have more than 3,000 outpatients.
OPD more than 3,000?
More than 3,000 per day. And then inpatients of more than 600 inpatients per day. And we have duplicated the facilities in the radiology or the other faculties because we run both the hospitals. Mm-hmm. And they are being run at a very low pricing.
And this is just 20 kgs. And how many times do you do this?
4 days a week. Every day you read 3 or 4. Write three, right hand.
Entire assortment, I am being told, one of the biscuits really famous, the Osmania one.
Yeah, Osmania one.
Is it? What's so special about that?
Well, this was made for the Nizam.
Huh.
And then it was given to the patients in Osmania Hospital.
Okay.
And then the secret came out and then it started becoming Osmania biscuit. Now this Irani chai.
Huh. Achha, this is Irani chai. It's not normal chai, is it?
It's known as Hyderabadi Irani chai.
Okay.
And so the Iranians who came to Hyderabad, they started making this tea.
I'm told you're supposed to dip the Osmania biscuit in the Irani chai.
Yeah, yeah.
Too sweet for you, Mr. Owaisi,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, now so since...
bitter mind like me is sweet.
Okay, coming to Ayodhya, Mr. Owaisi, these elections, you know, as much as people like you or perhaps even me may not want Ayodhya and Ram Mandir to become the issue, would you say, Mr. Owaisi, that still the land there, the disputes there, the Ram Lala temple there, all of that is an article of faith for the Hindus?
No, it is not.
And why would you say that?
Because Supreme Court is not dealing a matter of faith. They are dealing a title suit.
And let's not go by Supreme Court technicalities. I am asking you about it. You are a leader of a community.
Would you say,
Mr. Owaisi, that just in the same manner, then the land that belongs to the Babri Masjid, where it was demolished, restoring that to the Muslim community is also not an article of faith for Muslims?
I am fighting a battle of justice.
No, you're not answering. Answer my question.
I am answering you. I am answering you. It is a simple title suit. And I also...
You don't attach emotions to that.
What? My emotions are attached to justice.
मालिक का काम है पूछना, बताओ उसका जिम्मेदार कौन है, इसका कोई जवाब इनके पास नहीं.
Mr. Owaisi, thank you so much, sir, for your time, the entire day that you spent with us, and wishing you all the very best for 11th of April.